In this lecture, let's see how we can use FancyBox to display images, HTML elements, or even multimedia elements in a very nice and elegant way. FancyBox is actually a tool which is built on the top of jQuery library to display images, HTML elements, or multimedia elements in a lightbox style. That is, when you click on an image, it will get displayed as if it floats on the web page. You can easily create image galleries using FancyBox. So in this lecture, let's see how we can use FancyBox to display elements in a very nice and elegant way. To illustrate this, I have created a very basic HTML page and I have just added the reference to the required jQuery file. So this is the latest version of jQuery file. I have added it from the Google CDN. Next, what we want, we have to download FancyBox tool to use it in our web page. So to download the FancyBox tool, go to the site fancyapps.com/FancyBox. This is the website where you can download FancyBox tool. If you scroll down a bit, you could find license/download. As it is mentioned here, you are free to use FancyBox for your personal or non-profit website projects. And if you want to use it for commercial websites, you have to get the author's permission by paying a fee. So if you click this download button, it will start the download. I have already downloaded it. And in the downloads folder, FancyApps-FancyBox, this is the zip file. Just unzip it. So this is the unzipped folder. If you go within that and click the source folder, you will find some CSS and JS files which you need to reference in your web page which uses the FancyBox. So let me rename this folder to just FancyBox for easy referencing. Okay, so let me name it as FancyBox and let me move this folder to the same folder where this web page is lying, that is fancy-box.html is lying, so that I can just add reference like fancybox slash then the required JS or CSS files. So this is the folder where this fancy-box.html, that is this file, is lying, and I have copied fancybox to the same folder. Okay, now I want to add reference to this CSS and JS files. So how I can add reference after this jQuery? Let me add script type equals text or JavaScript src equals the name of the folder is FancyBox slash, it is in the source folder, right? This file is in the source folder. So let me write source then slash, then I need to copy this. So get info, copy this and paste it here. So this is the reference to the required JS file for the FancyBox to work. Then I have to add reference to the CSS file as well. So how I can add reference to a CSS file? I can specify ring rel equals style sheet, then type equals text slash CSS and href equals, let me copy this. And let me check the name. It is jQuery.fancybox.css. So I just have to change this. Hope you understand this part. I am adding reference to the required FancyBox.js and FancyBox.css files. I have specified FancyBox as the name of the folder. As you could see here, FancyBox is the name of the folder. And within that, source is another folder. And within that, the CSS and JS files lie. So I have added reference to the required JS and CSS files. Next, what we need to have some images, multimedia files or HTML elements to make them look beautiful. Okay, so let me add a div element within this body, div id equals, let me add the id as thumbs. And instead of adding the images statically, I'm going to add them dynamically using jQuery. So if you have already completed the image gallery project, you might be knowing how we can do that. So let me add an image array where imgarr equals, let me add the location of some images in this array. If you see here, I have an images folder as well. So let me add the images of some flowers here. I have flower1.jpg, png, flower2, flower3, up to flower7. So let me add the location of images in this imgarr. So when I specify the location as this fancybox.html and images folder lie in the same folder, I can just specify images slash then the name of the file. So if I specify flower2.jpg, okay, I have to specify it within double quotes. Okay, like this, let me add a couple more files. Okay, now I have added 5 images in this img array. That is, the location of 5 different images are added in this img array. Now I am going to use the each method to add all these images into this thumbsdiv. So how I can do that? Let me access the each method, $.each, and then I need to specify the name of the array through which I want to loop. So it is imgarr. Then I can call the function with index and value as the parameters. So let me specify index, which will start from 0, and value will be the corresponding value in the imgarr. So index value will be 0, then images slash flower2.jpg, 1, then the value will be images slash flower3.jpg. It will go like that. Next, I want to add these items to this div element. So how I can do that? If you find it a bit difficult to understand, please finish the image gallery project where I have explained this in very detail. So here I am going to append this to this div element. So how I can access it? I can specify $#thumbs, which means the div element, dot append. Okay, and I need to add the images. So I can specify img src equals, I need to specify this as the src because the value will be different each time as it loops through this imgarr. So let me put a plus, then value, then again a plus, then close this src's opening value, that is a single quotes. Then I can just close this img tag and then close this string. So this will append all the images to this thumbs div element. Now these images will be added. Let's see the change in the output. Let me refresh. See, these images are actually very big. That is why these are displayed like this. So we need to style this a bit so that they will be displayed in a single row as very small icons.